If you want insane deals on legit PC keys from great developers, use my Fanatical link down below and start saving yourself some money. What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Big Fry. Shout out to the subscribers. Guys, today we were blessed by the Farm 51 gods, and they are letting us talk about our first impressions of the closed technical test of World War III. So this is something I've been waiting for a while. However, I'm just going to start this video off by saying the recent trend of developers allowing YouTubers and content creators to talk about their impressions without actually giving us the ability to provide visual feedback is something that I'm not really enjoying. The Cycle did the same thing. They let people play the alpha. I can talk about the alpha, but I can't show you guys anything of what I'm talking about. I find that very strange, especially in World War III's case, where we have gameplay from Gamescom. Everybody knows what the game looks like. This is the gameplay you're seeing on screen here. The bugs that I've ran into in this technical test are pretty much the same ones you guys can see on screen when there's guys like you're shooting somebody and they're body just kind of ragdolls and it just looks really weird. Some of those kind of visual glitches are still prevalent in the build that I played. So what's the big deal with not allowing us to show just everything? Let's talk about it. The release date is in 2 weeks and we're going into early access. So right now, if I were to show a bunch of gameplay and be like, man, this is fucking garbage, all you're going to do is have a bunch of fanboys jump down my throat and say, it's in beta and is going into early access, Fry. So what's the big deal? Just let us talk about it. So if I have specific gripes about the game that I want to discuss, I can show the people, like, this is what I'm talking about. Anyways, that's just my quick little rant before we get into it. The Farm 51 presenting World War III. What do I think about it? Well, I did a really short playtest with World War III, and what I found was the gameplay itself was actually, an okay experience. It wasn't anything like oh my god, this is the best fucking game ever, but it definitely wasn't bad. I feel like there's a lot of potential with the gunplay. The game feels a little bit stiff running around. The map that we were playing on, I honestly don't even remember the name, but it's really dark and dreary. You guys are basically seeing it on screen here. It's super dark and gray, and it's honestly kind of like depressing to play on. Now, again, I was only able to play in one match. I actually got called into work halfway through the playtest, but it's okay. It's definitely not even close to the worst game that I'm going to play, and it's actually probably one of the more enjoyable experiences that I've had this year in terms of shooters, but for me, the game just felt almost robotic in a sense, and what I mean by that is the map is like just really dark and dreary. The game just feels kind of stiff. The map is very open, and there's a lot of areas that just aren't utilized at all. At one point, I kind of realized I was able to pick up a rocket launcher and just kind of run around without any sort of penalty. I was just literally rocket launchering guys around corners. So I would run out, see them back up, lean the corner, shoot the rocket, and I actually did pretty good with it. There's a lot of things that I really got to deep dive the gameplay to give you guys, like, my full impressions of every, like, weapon, our guns balance. Like, I haven't gotten into that. This is literally just very primary impressions. And once I'm able to, like, create content on a regular basis, and just deep dive it and give you guys videos, then that's when we're really going to get into the meat and potatoes of what this game is. Now, let's talk about this price tag, because the game is coming out at $28 US. It's going to be about, I'm going to say, about $32, $33 Canadian. For that price, a game going into early access is instantaneously going to scare off a large number of players. I know a lot of people seem to think that early access games should be priced anywhere from $24 and lower for them to even give the game a consideration. Price tag is everything when it comes to early access, especially day one launch. I feel like if this game comes out at $28 and then maybe for an early access launch price, they do a 10% discount to try and get it in more places, get it in more people's faces, maybe we'll see a better turnout. I'm hoping that that price tag is good. I know there's people that are going to sit here and be like, man, $28 is cheap, bro. And I get it. Some people are cheap. Again, this is all relative. I just know a large number of PC gamers look for the cheapest games on Steam that can give them the most bang for their buck. Early access title at $30, pretty tough sell for a lot of them. I know that just from personal experience from watching this market. I guarantee you there's a lot of people who wouldn't have jumped on Insurgency Sandstorm had there not been a 20% discount on the game pre-ordering it. I guarantee you that half the people playing it wouldn't have jumped on it. They would have waited for the game to go down in price around the holiday season maybe, and then jumped on it then. It's just the way it goes. All I'm thinking going into October 19th is that these guys have a really good showing for early access. There is a lot of people that I am seeing on the Discord for World War III that are basically jumping down people's throats for stating this. And I'm going to state this. This is a fact. First impressions, regardless of what state your game is in, are everything when it comes to gaming. I'm sorry to say, if you come into early access and you are playing like trash, you are going to have a very rough time winning back people. Even if you do the updates, even if you do the marketing, first impressions mean everything. And what I hope in this small technical test, I thought the game ran pretty good. I know my boy Mocha was having a fuck of a time with the first test. I believe I jumped in on the second one just because of the time zone differences. It ran pretty well for me. What I hope is when we get a lot more people coming in from early access that A, your servers will hold up. B, the game won't fucking tank when you have multiple servers of full players running around. All I hope for is that you guys have a great showing day one. You guys have about 2 weeks. And from what I saw, the game is in a decent state to be launching into early access. I just hope that that decent state, and I've seen this so many times, when a game is in a closed beta, when it's a small player base, and everything's running good and smooth, and then when it hits early access or it hits the Steam store, things go very, very wrong. Take a look at Scum, for instance. Scum is something that I fucking loved when it was in a small closed beta state. And as soon as it was open to the masses, that game took a fucking shit kicking. And I don't know if the game has even recovered yet. And that is really, really unfortunate. World War III, I just hope that you guys have enough time to make sure that that's not going to happen. Let me know what you guys think down below. If you guys haven't played the game, let me know what you're looking forward to. I'll try to get it covered in a future video. If it's a certain gun, a certain game mode, a certain type, just let me know. We'll have a conversation. And if you guys haven't played, I really want to hear your guys' thoughts in the comments below. Thank you guys for watching. If you haven't subscribed to the channel already, make sure you do. I'm shooting for 100,000 subscribers this year, and I think we're going to get it. My name is Big Fry, and I'll see you on the next one.